spit in the face of people who don't want to be cool.
You know what cool is? You're looking at.
It's your local neighborhood Negro, Axel Omega 10, back at it again with another video. Today, we will be reviewing Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot's story consists of all your favorite Dragon Ball Z moments in greater depth than they have ever been before in any game. With around 30 hours of gameplay, you play as all your favorite Dragon Ball Z characters through their greatest moments. With that comes an RPG aspect where you get to play as some of your favorite Z fighters and unlock some of your favorite moves through training or story progression. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot is a medium-paced game with some of the mechanics from other Dragon Ball Z games. With the mechanics of this game and the way the enemies are set up, everybody's fight, instead of opponent, seems more like a boss battle instead of an opponent. Now, not all matches feel like that, but through the progression of the story, you will feel like that. What sets this game aside from other Dragon Ball Z games is that the pacing of the enemies differ from enemy to enemy, so you have to fight each enemy differently. What I hated was that as I'm flying around in the story, trying to complete the story, I'd have these enemies come and try to jump me, and it's not that they were hard, they were just very tedious. Another thing that I just found to be very unnecessary was they would send you to find materials in the middle of the game, and it would interrupt the stories for long periods of time. And usually this would be coming in the middle of an intermission, and the intermissions I feel like were dragged on a little bit too long. Who should cop this game? Well, Dragon Ball Z lovers and just lovers of Dragon Ball Z should definitely cop this game for sure. We're in a gaming slump right now where new games haven't been released in months. Call of Duty sucks. It's a goodbye. You definitely shouldn't buy this if you're really just not interested in the Dragon Ball Z story, or you're not up to reliving the same game over and over again. That's understandable. But if you love Dragon Ball Z and like you love the story and you want to live some nostalgia, well, this is your game. Honestly, in my opinion of this game, I would give this game probably a 10 out of 10. I enjoy playing this game for a very, very long time. When I wasn't playing with some of my friends, this is the game I would be playing, and this consumed about half of my day every day for about 4 days. With the gaming slump that we are currently in, you know, even if you're not a fan of Dragon Ball Z, I definitely recommend to buy this game. This game has a lot of replayability. And with the gaming slump that we're going to have for the next year until the next generation consoles, it's a good game. It's a good game to just grind out. It's fun, and, you know, it has a lot of replayability. For those who aren't just big Dragon Ball Z fans, and you're just interested in the game that you can play, I'd wait for this game to drop down to about $30 to $25 on the gaming market, which, yeah, it's going to be some months until you're able to play it, but we have a year of this gaming slump, so that's more than enough time for the price to drop. This has been your local neighborhood Negro, Axel Omega 10, with the latest reviews. Like and subscribe down below, and peace.
Cross my way, you gotta come all the way,
all the way.
Baby, don't cross the fade,
cross
come
the
all the way. Baby, don't know how I'm feeling. Tell me what is reeling. Simple mind, all the shit we're feeling. I don't know how to get it. Trying to get this money with the riches. But I'm trying to get this money, sticking them with it. All the niggas with it. I'm trying to go ahead and get it, but how the budgets are with it, though?
Tell me to slow down. Baby, I'm in my zone now. Leave me alone now. Don't hit my phone now. I'd rather be alone now. I hate this feeling.